everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm making carne asada super nachos. So if you guys want to know how to make this, hit that subscribe button and watch me cook. So you guys are going to notice that I'm using 2 pounds of flank steak, but you don't need that much for this recipe. I just made the extra so that I can have it for like tacos, nachos, breakfast burritos, whatever else, just making it ahead of time. I'm adding all of my ingredients into a gallon size Ziploc bag just to make it easier. If you notice with my limes, I did roll them to try to help release some of the juices. These limes aren't giving me enough juice, so I did end up using a fork to help me out. You'll see that I grabbed a fork and I stuck it right inside of the lime, moving it around to help release some of the juices, and you'll see how much more it actually releases. Huge difference. It's harder to tell from this view, but I am adding salt and pepper right into the bag. You can see the little specks on top right there. I'm also adding 1/4 cup of vegetable oil. If you don't have the white vinegar, you don't have to add it, but it does help tenderize the meat. So if you can, go ahead and add 2 tablespoons worth. Don't skip out on the orange juice and make sure you add your cumin and your chili pepper into the bag. Now all we have to do is seal this up, making sure you fold it over, pressing out all the air, sealing it tightly so we don't have anything falling out. And just give it a nice massage until everything is nicely coated and marinated sitting inside the bag. Let this sit for a couple of hours up to overnight. Moving on to our simple guacamole. It's been about 6 hours and I went ahead and diced up my avocados, tomatoes, and onion. And I'm gonna place all these into a bowl. I'm also using the juice of 1/2 of a lime. I'm also using pre-minced garlic, about 1 teaspoon's worth. And I'm gonna throw some salt in there as well. And all we have to do is mash this up to our preference. If you like it smoother, if you like it chunkier, that's up to you. I ended up mashing mine until it's a little bit of both. I like a little bit of chunk in there just because it's just good with every bite. So sometimes when I go to a restaurant and I order this, they accidentally throw in a fry. And that's what made me come up with this idea. Except since I'm using nachos, I didn't want super crispy hash browns or super crispy fries. And so I went ahead and just used the hash browns, shredded hash browns, and I cook them just so they're a little bit soft and not too crunchy. If you're gonna use French fries, I highly suggest the shoestring fries because the crinkle cuts or the bigger cuts, it just doesn't work well, I think. That's my personal opinion. So continue cooking your hash browns until your likeness, your preference, whatever it is that you prefer. And I like to cook it until they're just a little bit brown on each side with my corn and all the water has dissolved from it. All I'm gonna do now is set these aside in the warm pan until I'm ready to put it into my bowl. Moving on to our steak, I went ahead and used my stovetop grill pan on a high heat and I'm cooking my steak until my likeness. Cook it until you prefer your meat well done, medium well, rare, whatever it is that you like. I did end up cutting my steak in half and I used 1/2 where it was medium well and the other half I ended up letting it cook a little longer for my girls. Now all we're gonna do is slice it. Again, this is up to you. If you want to cut it into large slices like this and layer it on top of your nachos, that's perfectly fine. Or if you want to dice it up like I'm going to be doing, I'm just going to turn it into bite-sized pieces so that we can get more onto each nacho. Now all we have to do is assemble it. I'm just going to add my hash brown and corn rind on top, grabbing a spoon to spread it around evenly. Grab whatever cheese you prefer and add as much or as little as you'd like all over this. Grab your beef and put that right in the middle and your guacamole and add that on the side. If you like the crumbly cotija cheese, go ahead and put that right on top as well. And I didn't show you guys, but I made pico de gallo, but grab your favorite salsa or whatever toppings it is that you like on top of this. If you guys like this recipe, please hit that subscribe button. And until the next meal, thank you for watching. Watch me cook.